gonna see the chat. What's going on? I can't see who's on here. Let me see. What's going on, y'all? Can you hear me okay? Hey, what's up? Okay. First slide. I wasn't too sure if this chat was working, man. I've been trying to get this thing going on my computer, on my laptop. I don't know what was going on, but ended up having to do this on my phone. So I just wanted to throw a quick fishing report. Give a few more minutes, see if anybody else gets on. I guess the Astros are getting ready to start, or they probably started already. But yeah, Seawolf Park was packed. It was packed from the very beginning. Can you hear me okay? All right. Hey, what's going on, Chris? And Savando, appreciate you guys jumping on. Y'all going fishing this weekend? Yes, sir. Yeah, I'm real parched, so I'm drinking, trying to drink off camera. Where y'all going? Hey, what's going on, Rolo? Y'all going to Galveston? Yeah, but you know, I just cut to the chase. You know, it was the surf was dead today. Man, it looked nice though. It was flat as heck. You can see that line. I don't know if you can get to it and if you can get to it in your kayak. But yeah, the surf was flat and you saw that nice clear separation of line where the dirty water meets the clean. No water in Galveston. You know, Rolo, a lot of the water came back. Friday, had some friends of mine go take a look at it. And Friday it was completely gone all the way out. And today I went back out there and a lot of it came back in. So, but you're right. I mean, still all around Bayou Vista, it's all still dry. But I'm thinking tomorrow it's probably going to come in more. That tide's going to keep coming. You know, today the wind was still out of the north a little bit. I think it's going to be moving toward the east and by Monday be moving out of the south. But I went out there, went to Seawolf Park this morning and got out there. There was probably like maybe about 6 in the morning. There were probably about 15 people out there. So we went out there in the dark and nothing. Nobody caught anything. It was probably 50 to 70 people out there. All on the right side. Ministry. Oh, that's awesome because everybody I talked to, I know a couple of friends of mine were in boats fishing around some bulkheads. They weren't, they think between four people in 5 hours, they caught like four. Only one was a keeper. And I didn't see anybody catching anything. On the left side, there was probably like maybe about 10, 12 people in Seawolf Park. We fished the right side, but ended up going to the left side. Yeah, today was a nice day too, though. Today was real nice. So we fished Seawolf Park for a little while. I want to say maybe close to 3 hours. Did you fish the sulfur docks, Chris, today? Because the friends of mine were over there and they didn't see anything. They didn't have any action this morning. Yeah. Were you throwing live bait? I think they were throwing artificial. But after Seawolf Park, we head over to South Jetty. Both, yeah. We hit a South Jetty and it was dead. You can see, you know, a few flounder prints, you know, right on the shoreline there, but no one was catching any flounder. No flounder being caught in South Jetty. But there was some nice reds being caught. I mean, if you're looking for reds, that's definitely a spot I will go to, is the South Jetty. Yeah, the water was pretty dirty. I don't know why I had my earpiece in my ear. I couldn't hear crap. But yeah, I saw somebody catch a nice 38-inch red off the drop there in the channel side. And a couple of nice reds being caught. Probably like four nice reds being caught off the rocks. So, but I don't know, man. It's tough. You know, it's the last weekend of flounder season. And like I said, there's like 70 people out there. And I didn't see one single flounder being caught. You know, there's a lot of bait buckets in the water. Like we were throwing mostly gulp. A couple friends of mine, they threw some DSL. But there was nothing to be caught out there. So it's tough. It's tough going, you know. The only thing I could think of, even with all the water being drained out, is why we're not seeing a run, is just the simple fact that, you know, the water temperature just isn't cold. It's not cold yet. It doesn't feel cold. And which is kind of new for me and surprising that when you do have that water drain out, you know, it typically means that the flounder are going to push and you're gonna catch some good numbers. At least it's been my experience in the past. So there's kind of, you know, kind of new experience where you see all that water dump and you don't see a bunch of big numbers of being caught. Like Chris was saying, you know, I mean, a few people catch, you know, catching here and there, you know, able to find them, you know, but you can find flounder throughout the season. It's most of these places, any place where you have structure. But I think just missing that water temp dropping is, I think, what's really lacking that big run and get those big number bites. But you know, I know Cody was out fishing a few times this week before work, and I put a lot of trust and a lot of faith in Cody because I know that guy, he can catch a lot of fish, and he's skunked out both days. So it's just, you know, he's like my human fish finder. Whenever we go out, I always want to know what he's throwing and how he's fishing his lure, so I can do the same thing, mimic him and get a fish. But yeah, man, it's tough. It was tough today. There was four of us. Hey, what's up, Slick Rick? You've been seeing them in grass line? Yeah, you know, I haven't been in the kayak. I need to get back in the kayak more. I got hung up this past summer, you know, chasing all those specks in the surf, you know, hunting, chasing Spanish mackerel and specks in the surf, that I kind of slacked off the kayak a lot, especially when you know, making friends with boats. So, yeah, no, I need to get back in the kayak. I need to fish more kayak, especially right now. You know, I missed out on a lot of reds in the grass line. But, you know, I just want to get on here real fast and tell everybody what's up and give them a fishing report. You know, fishing didn't look good today. I know a few friends of mine are going back out in the morning, but I think I'm going to hold back and probably wait till like Monday and Tuesday and hope that water starts coming back in and it stirs stuff up. What have you been throwing, Rolo? You want to share? What you been throwing in the grass line? Because I know you're always hooking up. No problem, big timer. I know it is actual time. I need to go too. Tight lines, Chris. Appreciate you jumping on here. What are you throwing, Rolo? What have you been throwing? I see you catching a lot of reds, you know, in your kayak out there. I'm just kind of curious what you've been fishing with. Rolo don't want to talk. It's all good. But yeah, but that's gonna wrap it up. Like I said, I just want to jump on here real fast and tell everybody, you know, we're not catching. You know, I've fished Chocolate Bayou in the past. I've seen some really nice flounder come out of Chocolate Bayou. I've caught a few nice reds in there, but I haven't fished in a while. I guess maybe about 3 or 4 months ago. Artificial lures. Yeah, thanks. But no, yeah, I haven't fished in a long time, but I've seen some nice flounder come out of there as well. But no. But yeah, I just wanted to get on here and tell you guys what's up. You know, the fishing was tough. I hope you guys get out there and able to get some of those flatties. You know, tomorrow's the last day that you'll be able to keep them to after December. But I just think this year is going to be a late run. You know, hopefully we'll see some good numbers in December. So, but hey, man, thanks for jumping on here, guys. I appreciate you. I'm going to jump off here and get watching the game. But thanks again. You have a good night. Tight lines, y'all.